From the White House to social media, critics say Indiana's new law discriminates against gays and lesbians. But Governor Mike Pence says those critics are missing the point of the law. He says it's about protecting Americans from government overreach. Gary Lane has the story.
After protesters took to the streets in opposition to the Indiana law, and celebrities unleashed a flurry of critical tweets, Indiana Governor Mike Pence took to the airwaves. He explained the purpose of the state's Religious Freedom Restoration Act is to protect people of faith, not discriminate against gays and lesbians.
The issue here is, you know, is tolerance a two-way street or not? I mean, you know, there's a lot of talk about tolerance in this country today having to do with people on the left. But here Indiana steps forward to protect the constitutional rights and privileges of freedom of religion for people of faith and families of faith in our state. And this avalanche of intolerance that's been poured on our state is just outrageous.
In fact, Pence and supporters of the Indiana law say it's similar to federal legislation signed by President Bill Clinton and laws approved by 19 other states, including Illinois. Back then, State Senator Barack Obama voted for it. The White House responded. Spokesman Josh Ernst said the bill Mr. Obama supported in Illinois did not legitimize discrimination. Critics say the Indiana law allows businesses like florists and bakeries to go unpunished when denying service to gay couples for religious reasons. That's happened in other states, where some Christians have already lost their businesses. On the ABC program this week, George Stephanopoulos attacked Pence on that point.
Do you think it should be legal in the state of Indiana to discriminate against gays or lesbians?
George.
It's a yes or no question.
Hoosiers don't believe in discrimination. This is about protecting the religious liberty of every Hoosier, of every faith.
And most people support the idea. One poll taken last February showed 57% of Americans believe business owners should not be forced to provide services for same-sex weddings if they have religious objections.
Meanwhile, the uproar is expected to continue. The NCAA has expressed concerns as Indiana prepares to host college basketball's Final Four.
And other companies and businesses may soon bow to pressure to boycott Indiana, possibly costing the state millions of dollars in tax revenues. Gary Lane, CBN News.